I think just in general, it's amazing in the last 30 years how many people have been able to spend their lives making things as opposed to before. I mean, people decide, no, I'm not going to have a 9-to-5 job. I'm going to hustle, I'm going to work here so I can then make things, whether it's video or whatever it is. But obviously video is it's a tool that relates to a lot of everyday things that makes it kind of appropriate to try and to deal with our realities. So I think that in this way, it's a fantastic thing that's so cheap now. People can do things abundantly, even if there's lots of crap.
Yeah. About the creatorship, he wants to know how was the process of choosing the words that are being included here, if there's a concept or it's a retrospective of some sort. How did you choose? How are they linked?
It's really a multiplicity of things. I mean, and one, of course, is the limitations of shipping, you know, what is available, I mean, all kinds of things. If you were to start from scratch and I was to say, what would make sense? I mean, you know, there's infinite possibilities. So, that, you know, there's real life limitations that help to form that. I mean, obviously a word like viewer, I think, works really well here. First of all, there's not a language issue. And it does have people from the Southern Hemisphere in it. you know, I think that just is almost like a kind of natural word. Part of the other choices were simply, you know, I think as an artist, things that you've recently done, you like to show. So I wanted to try to include some of the more recent works, Up Against Down and Unconditional Surrender. On the other hand, I think that these do, and even the wall piece, there is a connective tissue amongst these works. There's a kind of, I mean, most of these things have to do with someone being in the space with kind of almost like a mirrored experience of themselves. I mean, these pieces very much are about kind of like, you know, what am I? You know, what it is to think? What is it to view? They're very, you know, phenomenal, ontological. They're very much about thinking, about being, and in some sense being with others. Or being with yourself.
Pray. It wants me to see through sleep. It wants me to act but knowledge. It wants acknowledgement.
And so in this sense, I think these pieces share this, albeit it's, you know, it's quite wide, but I think that this is where they overlap.
Oh, it's the last question already. It's going to be fun.
Already, I'm at the beginning. Yeah, that's where the fun starts. You have to peel back the layers. Actually, this may turn into a lengthy thing or not, but I did a work called Glass Onion. The title of it was Glass Onion, which at the time I finished it. At the end of 1980, 1981, and John Lennon had just been shot dead. And he wrote a song called Glass Onion. It's on the double white album, I think.
He wrote it?
Yeah,
because
well,
of the rock?
No.
I
decided to, it's two things. One is it was a perfect title for this piece I was doing.
Yeah.
And it was kind of as a homage to.
Oh, okay. So you gave the title.
Right. But this goes back to your first question, you know, about kind of maybe something to do with video, nature of video. And Glass Onion is referring to this piece involves there's a monitor that is face up on the floor. This is going to be complicated. So,
okay.
And then there's four monitors that represent the corners of a rectangle, so quite large, maybe half the size of this room. And then there are four speakers that are, you know, you have the monitor, then four speakers, then four more speakers, and then four monitors. So you have these concentric squares that are, you know, pathways you can walk from here, you know. And the wires that connect everything draw out this kind of diagrammatic rectangle. And there's a camera on the ceiling which continuously zooms in and frames the monitor on the ground and zooms out and frames the outer rectangle of the space. Now on the monitor on the ground is, you know, quite literally video feedback, but it's made with negative feedback, so that when the camera sees itself, that image gets inverted, and so that the camera sees itself inverted, so it's black square on a white square on a black square on a white square, right? And depending on how close the camera is how many squares you will see until it just reaches this threshold limit where it'll just kind of flow into a morphic, you know, shapes or whatever. I mean, this is generic feedback in some sense. But the difference here is that, so I wrote a text that is a description of feedback. I can tell you the whole text right now, actually.
Yeah?
Should I?
Yeah.
Okay. It goes like this.
Do you remember?
Yeah, I do, I think. And it goes, but the nature of this text is that it is revealed from the end back to the beginning. So you hear the end first, and then it layers the whole thing on top of it. Okay? So the whole text is, a texture is drawing, a continuum from one voice to another, differentiated by measuring the distances between sending monitor and receiving messages voicing the following. Rectilinear time enfolds feedback, the negative and positive spaces, expanding the image, the idea, that text, the written description of the feedback, occupies the space before and after the frame of reference within a rectangle. Okay, now this whole paragraph is written kind of mathematically so that the syllables break into kind of parts of threes. So you have, and then the text is chanted, and the first, third, fifth, and seventh tracks are panning on four of the speakers, and the second, fourth, and sixth tracks are panning on the next layer of speakers. And it's chanted, so you hear, so when it first starts on that monitor, you'll see just one rectangle within the rectangle, and then actually the text is written, and it's crawling on the outer monitors, on this, you know, the four outer monitors in the box, right? And you hear rectangle, 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 and then you'll see another rectangle within the rectangle, so there's two, and then you hear a voice come and say, within a rectangle. So you see, within a rectangle is six syllables, rectangle is three syllables, so that when rectangle is said the second time, you'll hear two voices saying it simultaneously. Okay, and the frame of reference within a rectangle, you'll hear two people say within a rectangle, and then you'll hear three people say rectangle.